roots.
This is red twig dogwood.
So as you just saw, I just re-prepped this like cold frame bed. Last year I tried it and I had water issues, so it was draining too fast. The front half, I don't know if you can see the eaves trough, but hangs out about halfway over this. So the front half got snow and water and everything throughout the seasons, but then the back half was just dry the whole time. So I don't know if you noticed, I put new sand down the front, and then I put some older, more like clay sand that'll hold water better along the back, and then I did a layer of peat on top. And I just watered it in really good with two full buckets. So now we're ready to plant some new cuttings. The other thing is, I have soil heating cables under here, and I'm gonna plug them in now. So we are getting negative temperatures at night, and it keeps the soil about 7 degrees, so right where we want roots to grow, it's a little bit warmer, and then up top, it's exposed, so it'll stay dormant, theoretically, and not grow. And now, I'll have to keep an eye on the water this time. So even through the winter, if it's not packed with snow to insulate it, I'm going to have to water it, or else the water and ice will sublimate right out, and it'll be dry. Today we're doing things properly. I got my cutters, my pruners. This is a half peroxide, half water. And then my new addition, I got Hormex number 8. So this is for evergreens and, oh shit, that's the wrong one. Be right back. Son of a bitch. Okay. Hormex 16, which is 1.6% IBA. This is for hard to root stuff. I'm actually, for the first time, gonna dump a wee little bit into a separate container. To keep my stock clear of disease. So these are Danica cedar, which I have a whole bunch of bushes out front that I trimmed. So I'm just going to strip ends off. I'm going to dip them in the peroxide. And that will basically wet them before I dip them into the rooting hormone powder. And then I'll just plant them. You'll see. So these were cut a while ago, so I'm gonna recut the bottoms. On some, if I tear some leaves off, I'm not gonna cut the bottom.
check out my little ergonomic setup. So much better for the knees, the back, and this old body. All right. So I'm going to keep going. These guys are too tall. I'm going to cut them in half and then do those cuttings down the row. So we'll start with that. Okay, this one I'm excited about, even though they probably won't work. So this year again, these are cutoffs from our Christmas tree, which we got a Concolor fir, and it smells amazing. It's kind of like pine, but very citrusy. It has really long, soft needles. It's very cool. So naturally, I'm gonna cut it all up and see if I can grow any. And funny story, last year I did our Christmas tree, which was a balsam fir, and out of all the cuttings I did in this prop box, two of those are the only things that rooted. So let's give it a shot. We'll see. I don't think it's going to work. Good morning. So this is a rare treat. It is Christmas Day, Zone 6B, Southern Ontario, Canada, and it's 10 degrees. Pretty sure that's called global warming. But anyways, I'm gonna do what I love, which is trying to propagate plants. One day I'll get it. To show you this one before I do it, and the sun's trying to come out. Also, don't mind the hair, this is getting taken care of today. Finally, look at that. So it looks pretty dead, right? Bazoom.
So this is Russian cypress. It's really cool. It's like an amber gold, kind of dead looking. But no, that's just its winter color. It's pretty wild. It's actually fully sunny out now. But I am moving on to my Elkhorn cedar. I already did a whole bunch of cutting of these indoors earlier, but they've all turned black and I don't really think there's much hope left for them. So I took some new ones and we're going to try them out here. This time I'm going to try and strip off some of these like scale leaf things and see if that helps. But I don't even know if they do strip off. We'll see. This weather is wild. Man, I cannot get over this weather. It's sunny out on Christmas Day and 10 degrees. Anyway, so here's where I got. First row, I'm not sure what it is. Quite possibly gold mop. Then we got variegated boxwood. And then we've got yew. And then we've got green velvet boxwood. And then we've got Danica cedars. And gold thread cypress. Emerald cedars. What's this guy? Trautman juniper, Concolor fir. What's this guy? That is that bright one out front. Vintage gold cypress, which is the brightest yellow all year long of all of my plants. And then we've got blue haven juniper, which is like a crazy like plum silver blue color. Russian cypress, which looks dead, but they're not. Gold emerald cedar, which are looking pretty good, and then Elkhorn cedar. So there might be a couple more I'll find and do, and then I kind of want to get some red twig dogwood, and I have some hardy kiwis, but I think that's going to be about it for this video. I'm not going to film any more of this stuff. Wish me luck. One of the other things I'm going to do, so my rain barrel's right there. I'm going to go find some big green branches of willow and stick them in there because I feel like that will be my like secret weapon. Because every time you water these, you're basically washing off the rooting hormone, right? So if I put willow branches in there, they are notorious for making their own rooting hormone. And I'll be watering them with more rooting hormone. That's the plan anyway. We'll see how it works. And the other thing is in the spring, I'm going to build a cover for this to keep the moisture in this year or this time, because this experiment last year basically didn't work except for like two twigs of balsam fir and then the red twig dogwoods that I didn't even mean to grow. But let's hope it all works out. And I guess have a good day. Bye.